Hey guys, what's up? I hope your week is going well. Today's video is all about urea, and this is an ingredient in skincare products that I want to emphasize and start talking about more on the channel. You guys have asked me about it a fair amount, and so that's what this video is about. I'm going to talk about urea, what it's useful for, what it does in the skin, and then I'm going to conclude at the end of the video by talking about some products that contain urea in them. So I hope you guys like this kind of content. You all seem to really enjoy my sulfur video. I really have a strong desire to push towards more videos that emphasize ingredients that have an established track record of being effective and are undersold. You know, they're not the sexy ingredients. So urea has a long-standing track record in dermatology for treating a variety of skin concerns, skin issues, and skin diseases. It is a tiny little molecule that is very lightweight and can easily cross the thick, waxy barrier of your skin to get into the top layer of that stratum corneum, that dry layer, your barrier. It can weave its way in there and impart numerous benefits, which I'll get into in today's video. It's a compound that our body makes internally. It is a natural compound that we make as humans. So when proteins are digested in the liver, urea is a byproduct. Urea then functions in our body, in the kidneys, in the renal system, to hold on to water so that we don't pee out all of our water. So it has a key role in maintaining the hydration status of our body. So it is a fantastic ingredient in skincare and has many properties that are very unique and are capitalized upon in a variety of topical formulations. Urea is not just within our body, a natural part of our body, but it's also a natural part of our skin barrier already. It's something that already is delivered. It has a specific delivery system to go from the body into the skin. There are specific channels, specific little proteins that get put into our skin to take up urea from our body, because it really has a key role in maintaining the skin barrier and the skin barrier hydration status. And therefore, it is something that we already make and use, and applying it topically to the surface of the skin further brings about additional benefit. You guys have heard me talk about humectants a fair amount in moisturizers. Another word for humectant is hygroscopic, just things that hold on to water. And they are key ingredients in moisturizers. So urea is often found in many moisturizers and moisturizing washes, etc., because of its keen ability to bind water and keep it in the skin. And routine use of moisturizers is an imperative part of a skincare routine. It is probably one of the few things that actually matters in skincare. That's it. You know, I want to keep emphasizing this to you guys. There are very few things that they're selling you out there that actually matter to your skin. And moisturizing on a consistent basis is something that actually matters, because not only as we get older, we become more deficient in our ability to repair our skin barrier, but diseases like acne, clogged pores, seborrheic dermatitis, rosacea, eczema, keratosis pilaris, they're all of these diseases, all of these conditions, all of these skin conditions and concerns, they all have an underlying skin barrier defect that needs to be addressed in order for the skin to repair itself and to function optimally. I dare say there is an individual out there who will not benefit from daily use of a moisturizer. But in addition to its hygroscopic benefits, urea also does something else. At higher concentrations, urea actually can help to dissolve some of the top layer of the skin, the dead stuff that is stuck on there and won't come off and is making your skin barrier not as effective. This is a problem that happens as we get older, as we get wiser, and in conditions like eczema, atopic dermatitis. There is this dryness and this stickiness and stuck on uselessness of the top layer of the skin, the stratum corneum. It does not turn over as smoothly as it should. It's almost got a kink in it. And a keratolytic agent can help in turning that over. Urea, in a concentration-dependent manner, can function as a keratolytic, meaning at higher concentrations, it will help to dissolve some of that. At lower concentrations, it is primarily a hygroscopic agent, but at higher concentrations in skincare products, it can not only work as a moisturizing ingredient, a humectant, but also to help skin cells turn over by exfoliating them. And because urea can help to turn the skin barrier over, help to exfoliate lightly the top layer of the skin, depending on the concentration of it, it also functions as a penetration enhancer, meaning it allows other active ingredients more access into the skin. It helps open up the doors, if you will, to allow those ingredients to penetrate into the skin barrier much more effectively. So, in addition to being a hygroscopic, meaning holding on to water and helping the skin turn over as a keratolytic, and also allowing ingredients to penetrate more readily, urea also helps to stabilize the lipids in your skin barrier, and that's really important. One of the consequences of bathing and of cleansing and of washing the skin and using soaps, detergents, no matter how gentle they are, is that they disrupt the lipid orientation in our skin barrier and lead to more loss of water out of the skin and impair the skin barrier further. No matter the cleanser. Urea incorporated in moisturizers actually can help the lipids in our skin stay straight and upright and do what they have to do. So it enforces the lipid bilayer, reinforces it. We also have mounting evidence that urea as an ingredient, both that our body makes and that we have put onto the surface of our skin, can actually be helpful in activating the expression of certain genes that are key and important in our skin barrier homeostasis. The homeostasis of our skin barrier is this exquisitely coordinated series of events that can get a little stiff and out of sync, particularly as we get older or in certain skin conditions and concerns that lead to dry skin. So urea can help all of that to get back on the path to behaving properly. It really can. And when I talk to you guys about how the skin barrier becomes impaired and how we become deficient in some of these processes as we get older, really what I'm talking about is something called the natural moisturizing factor. These are components of our skin, of the top layer of our skin that our body makes and puts out there to hold on to water and to allow that that unique and complicated network that comprises our barrier that protects us from the outside world. Those factors, those natural moisturizing factors, are something that our body produces and allows the skin to function optimally. It keeps everything lubricated and smooth and fluid and nicely acting as a shield. All right, so I told you all of the great things that urea can do. What are the specific skin issues and skin concerns that are addressed by urea? Well, dry skin in general can be helped by urea, but specific skin conditions that are alleviated by the use of urea or aided, the recovery and repair is aided by the use of the ingredient urea, include psoriasis. I mentioned how urea not only helps as a moisturizer, but it also helps allow other active ingredients to penetrate into the skin much more easily. And I also mentioned that at higher concentrations, urea is a keratolytic. So those properties make it a wonderful ingredient for use in psoriasis, because psoriasis, if you're not familiar, is characterized by thick, scaly plaques of red skin. Urea helps to hydrate that skin. It helps to make other ingredients get into that skin affected by the psoriasis more easily, and it helps to turn over some of that scaly built up stuff on the surface of it. So it is a wonderful ingredient for that. I mentioned dry skin, of course. Also the condition seborrheic dermatitis on the face, on the scalp. Urea can help turn over some of that flakiness that occurs in seborrheic dermatitis, that flaky component that, you can develop scaliness around the nose, around the mouth, scaliness and flakiness of dandruff in the scalp. in the ears. Urea is a good ingredient for addressing that flakiness. But also, people with seborrheic dermatitis have an underlying skin barrier defect. So the hygroscopic features of urea help to address that component. And, you know, again, a very, very inexpensive ingredient. Urea is also fantastic for crumbly, peely nails, or what is referred to as dystrophic nails. Urea helps to not only hydrate the nail plate, but it also helps to exfoliate some of that scaly stuff on the surface of the nails, helps to improve the appearance of the nails themselves. And not only is it great for sort of rejuvenating the look of your fingernails and your toenails, but specifically it is an effective ingredient in foot creams and toe creams, toenail creams. It's an effective ingredient for little fungus that might develop in your feet, onychomycosis or tinea pedis. These are medical terms for toenail fungus and foot fungus caused by athlete's foot is another, it's commonly referred to. Urea, because it is a keratolytic, it helps to remove some of that built up scaly stuff on the feet around the nails. That built up scaly stuff is a very hospitable environment for fungus. Fungus thrives on that. And by employing a keratolytic like urea, helps to remove some of that good stuff that the fungus is snacking on. Not only that, a rate limiting step in the treatment of toenail fungus is actually getting the antifungal medicine to get into the nail. It's really hard to get it to penetrate into the nail to treat the fungus. Urea, because it enhances penetration of active ingredients, is a great ingredient to include in these foot creams and foot ointments to allow antifungals to get into the skin much more easily and be more effective. Urea, I already mentioned dry skin, and so in that vein, a skin condition that is helped by urea is obviously atopic dermatitis, which is known commonly as eczema. That is a wonderful ingredient for eczema, particularly eczema on the lower legs that is dry and scaly. It is also a phenomenal ingredient for the sister condition, which many people with eczema also have, keratosis pilaris. Not only will urea help to soften and hydrate the skin and help the skin barrier that is already impaired as part of the disease, but it will help to remove some of that built up bumpy stuff. Say one condition which you might want to proceed cautiously is rosacea. Rosacea is very sensitive skin. Products applied to the skin sting, burn. Urea can be sting as a result of its keratolytic properties, even at low concentrations. People with rosacea often are too sensitive to urea in skincare products. So those are some specific conditions for which urea is helpful. Before I get into the various products, just a few notes about what to look for in terms of ingredients. And because urea enhances the penetration of ingredients, it's really, really important here in particular when choosing a urea-based product to make sure that the product does not contain any fragrance. I don't care if it's natural or synthetic, no fragrance and no essential oils. The reason this is important is because those ingredients have no role other than adding scent to the product. But because urea allows more of them to get into your skin, it increases the risk that you will develop a sensitivity to one of those fragrance ingredients. So making sure there's no fragrance in the product is really, really important, okay? All right. When you look at the ingredient list, you might see the word urea by itself. You might also see the word hydroxyethyl urea. That is just another name for it. However, there are two ingredients that might appear on labels that are not the same thing as urea. They are imidazolidinyl urea and diazolidinyl urea. I will write these down below in the description box for you guys, so don't worry about memorizing them. Those are preservatives. They are formaldehyde releasers, which function as preservatives. They're not the same thing as the urea that I'm talking about here. They are not the active ingredient urea. I also mentioned that urea is a keratolytic, meaning it will exfoliate the skin in a concentration-dependent manner. Concentrations in the range of 10 to 25% yield a mild keratolytic effect. There are very mild exfoliants in that concentration. That is what you will find in the majority of over-the-counter body moisturizers, body lotions containing urea, that 10 to 25%. Higher concentrations like 40% urea, 50% urea, this is pretty robust. This is a more robust keratolytic. That is often what is given to people with psoriasis to their feet, for example, can be very helpful in those situations, but too high for the thin skin around the face. Most of the face products that you will find, the lotions intended for the face, they will contain a much lower percentage of urea, around 5%. Which can still have some mild keratolytic properties and be helpful for things like seborrheic dermatitis, but are easy to tolerate on the face. So those are some important things to be aware of. Alright, so now I'll get into the products that contain urea. And in the description box, I will just list all of these and I will put urea products for face, urea products for body, so you kind of know which is which. Okay, but for the face, one product that I really love is the Hadalabo Premium Hyaluronic Acid Lotion. This has urea in it. It also has, I believe, ceramides in it. It is a lightweight lotion that is very easy to tolerate, fragrance-free. It is lightweight, so if you want a thicker moisturizing cream that contains urea in it for the face, another one that is great by Hadalabo is their Perfect Gel. It has ceramides in it. It is a really, really nice, rich moisturizer. It comes in a gold jar. You can also get that on YesStyle. It's a great one. Okay, so those are two for the face. One that I tried a long time ago and personally didn't get along with too well, I felt it was a little sticky and tacky, but contains urea and is otherwise formulated very, very nicely, has a decent ingredient list, no offensive ingredients, is The Ordinary's Natural Moisturizing Factor. This is a moisturizer. It contains urea as well as ceramides, I believe. So it is a good one and a good alternative. And very affordable. I think it's like $5. You can get it at Sephora, I dare say, now. So there you go. All right, a product that you guys asked me about a fair amount is the Clinique Moisture Surge 72-Hour Auto Replenishing Hydrator. This also can be used on the face, but it too contains urea in it. So it's a good one. It does have red and yellow dyes in it, which are not necessarily bad, but for people with acne-prone skin, red and yellow dyes have been shown to irritate acne-prone skin. So be aware of that if that is you, but many of you love that product and swear by it. So you're getting some urea in there as a side note. Then another product for the face that you guys asked me about and I've tried and like is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Face Moisturizing Lotion. The one potentially problematic ingredient in that product is chrysanthemum extract. That is a plant derived compound. And if you have true fragrance allergy, that could potentially be a problem for you. So that would be my one bugaboo with that. But I believe First Aid Beauty is cruelty-free, which is great. So that's a cruelty-free option for you guys. Then for the face, this one is not in the US, but it's available to you guys in the UK. It might be you can get it on Amazon UK and have it sent here. Is the Eucerin Smoothing Face Cream 5% urea. This is a fantastic one. I have used it myself and it is great. All right, those are the ones for the face that I have here. And then for the body, there are tons. Eucerin, in the States, I know Eucerin makes a ton of body lotions and creams that contain urea in them that are great for keratosis pilaris on the body, that dry, scaly skin of just dry skin on the lower legs. If you describe your skin as ashy, using one of these body lotions, I'll list them down below from Eucerin. They're really good. I believe Curel also makes a urea-containing body lotion, too, that is quite good. The Aven Smoothing Exfoliating Cream for Body is one that I think is more affordable to you guys in Europe, France, UK. You guys, I think, is more more affordable than it is here. It's a little on the pricey side here for us, but that's a great body cream, a body lotion that contains urea in it as well. So that's an option. Speaking of Europe and products that you guys can get, La Roche-Posay has a line ISO-Urea. Their ISO-Urea body milk unfortunately contains fragrance, but they have another subline of that I've noticed, the La Roche-Posay ISO-Urea MD Balm. That is a urea cream that is fragrance free. And then from CeraVe, we have a few players here. The CeraVe Psoriasis Cream is a great one for really, really scaly skin on the body, on the feet. It has not only urea in it, but it has 2% salicylic acid. So when you use this, it's going to give you quite a bit of exfoliation. So it's a great one for that rough, bumpy keratosis pilaris on the upper arms. But because it is so exfoliating, if you're using it on areas of the body that are then exposed to sunlight, make sure you are wearing a broad spectrum sunscreen, because as it's thinning that crusty, scaly stuff, that was actually offering you a little bit of sunscreen, even though it was useless in barrier and keeping you protected from the outside world. It was offering you a little bit of sunscreen that you're now losing. So make sure, I mean, you always should be protecting your skin from the sun, but be a little more hypervigilant, because that's going to allow more sun to get in. And then lastly from CeraVe, you guys, I'm kind of disappointed. So CeraVe has this new diabetics line of moisturizers, and I believe they have a face wash as well? I can't quite remember. But anyways, the CeraVe Diabetics Dry Skin Relief. This is a urea-containing moisturizer, but they put orange and they put citrus extracts in it. I was taken aback by that. CeraVe really let me down with the inclusion of the citrus extracts in there. I'm sure that they will make some comment about how they are used as antioxidants for product stability, but I don't, they can still potentially cause problems for people with confirmed fragrance allergy. So I wish they hadn't put those in there. They're not good for diabetics who already have an impaired skin barrier. Diabetics, sorry, are another class of individuals who need to make sure they address their skin barrier. I didn't mention that. All right, and then lastly, I mentioned, that urea foot creams are great for foot fungus and for, toenail fungus, but also, even if you don't have those conditions, if you have scaly feet from callus buildup, from running, from walking, poorly fitted shoes, rather than going to the pedicure salons to have them peel that off, just going to come right back, using a urea-containing foot cream, which functions as a keratolytic, will allow that to soften, stay hydrated, and the skin to be healthy and hydrated. And you guys know I use Carousel foot ointment on my feet a couple of nights a week. I try to when I remember. But for those of you guys in the UK and Europe, other areas of Europe, I think, I'm almost certain, I got this on Amazon UK. That's why I say UK. This is the Eucerin Intensive 10% Urea Cream. So this is an option for you guys. Eucerin makes a lot of good urea creams. Eucerin, urea, I don't know if that's easy for you guys to remember, but yeah. Again, I will put all of these down below in the description box for you guys, and I'm just going to put face and list the products for the face, and then body and the products for the body. But just a note of caution, when you are pursuing this ingredient, try your very best to look for ingredients that are free of fragrance. I know it can be hard because cosmetic companies, they don't always disclose things necessarily as fragrance. Sometimes they'll tell you the product is fragrance free and it's not actually. So I know that can be a challenge to you, but if you see fragrance listed, then try and choose something else, because urea is a penetration enhancer, it just puts you at more risk for having problems with fragrance. That's about all I have to say about urea today, but like I said, I want to continue on this channel to make content about skincare ingredients that, as a dermatologist, I know work and I know are effective. And, the cosmeceutical companies, they come out with new ingredients, new lotions and potions every second. I mean, dermatologists, we can't keep up with all of this stuff because, it's kind of their word against ours. New growth factors, new peptides, new botanicals. And by and large, what I want to emphasize on here is stuff that I know works and I feel confident recommending to you guys, and I know has a track record, has the established efficacy. Stuff that my mentors would have used and recommended and shown benefit, you know, in the 60s and the 70s, and that we're still using today. That's the kind of stuff that I can feel confident talking to you guys about and promoting to you guys as skincare ingredients. Stuff that's affordable and stuff that you can get for your families easily in the drugstore. You don't have to go, you know, chasing some expensive skincare line to find it. I want to continue to point out those ingredients that I do feel comfortable do offer something to you. So I hope you guys like this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.